Hi, I'm Tia Daniels, and I'm here with my peer Tiana Stewart and author Mamadou Barrow. Thank you so much for meeting with us today. We really appreciate it. We're excited to meet you.
Thank you very much. Nice to meet you, too.
Thank you. So, for starters, can we get some more information about you? Can you tell us about yourself, you know, what you do?
Yes, of course. Thank you for having me, and you're very welcome here in Senegal. And hopefully, I mean, like, you're enjoying it. And yes, my name is Mamadou Barrow, and I'm from Senegal, and especially from Djoubel. Djoubel is a central area in Senegal, about 140 kilometers from Dakar. And yes, I'm getting old. I will be 28 in 5 months. Okay, so currently I'm a student at EIM, Institute of African Management. If you want, African Institute of Management. And I'm studying international business, so I'm enrolled in a program of master in international business. So that's a little bit about me.
So we're here to talk about your books, first of all. So we just have like to tell, like a little introduction on what they're about, what are your motivations, and what are some common themes that you intertwine into your books.
Yes, of course. That's very interesting. Yeah. You should know that these books should be just one. So we have, decided to split it into two books, based on the themes developed in that books. You know, the first one, Une jeunesse pour la relève. If you try to translate, is the youth we need for the taking over here in Africa and especially in Senegal. And then we know that now it's very important that youth has to take into consideration what is going on around the world, and then we have to take consideration our past and then our present, so that to prepare our future. And then we African people, you know, our history, and then people they don't know about us, but sometimes also they feign not to know about us, and then that's why we have to come up with something else, and then come up with something great, and that's why I have written this book. And the second one is just the Djoubel et des confréries, and if I can translate, is just it's about Djoubel and the Muslim Brotherhoods. Okay, so you know Djoubel, we got our independence in 1960, and then there nothing is there. It's just completely forgotten by officials and by politicians, and it should stop right away. It should stop, and we have to move forward. And I have tried to collect some data and working on them, and then come up with this book, and then that's it.
Okay, so what do you plan on doing with your degree in business management?
You know, as far as in 2016, if I'm not mistaken, I was enrolled in a traineeship. I have spent 11 months in a multinational company, container shipping company here in Dakar, and I have tried to I was familiarized with the international business, the international environment, and that's why I understand that English was very important. And I had to notice that the program within which I am enrolled is entirely taught in English. So back in the days, I understood that yes, English is very important as is a international language, and I should master it. And that's why I am in this program. And then I know that after this program, I can see some opportunities from everywhere, etc., and that's why.
Nice. So before we got on camera, you mentioned you were a little bit nervous about your English, but you're doing fine.
Yes.
Doing fine.
No, I can tell you. You know, English is a language that I really like. I love it. And then, yes, I'm doing plenty of efforts to master it. And then that's why sometimes when people are like, yes, your English is good, what? No, it's not very good. I'm just trying to make it, better and better and better. And that's it. And I know that there's a long way to go, and yes, I have to work on it and then continue to work on it.
Yeah. So do you have any advice, like what did you do to better your English, or do you have any advice for anybody out there that's a little bit nervous about trying or about mastering it? Do you have any advice?
Oh, yes. I spend a lot of time on YouTube. Yes, I decided not to watch TV. You know what? I mean, when you're in front of a TV, you are not choosing your program. So when you're in front of YouTube, for example, you choose what you're watching. Okay, so you can watch whatever you want. And then that's it. And then I have watched a lot of, not movies, but a lot of documentaries, a lot of speeches from those guys from America or from all around the world. And then that's how a little bit I have tried to master it. And with the help of some friends, and there's a friend who really helped me. His name is Mamoru Wang. He's a rapper. He's a Juba. He's from Juba like me. And then he was like giving me some tutorials. I remember there's one tutorial from Rachel's English. I don't know if you guys know about her. And then she's teaching, I mean, those people who are not American, teaching them how to speak English like a native speaker. And I practice it, and then yes. And then sometimes I spend my time to read a loud voice and then to make it happen.
Interesting. Do you have any other books that you plan on publishing or writing? Do you have any ideas in the future?
I spend a lot of time dealing with those two books, and then that's why I have started a novel. But for some reason I have stopped it, and I think with this publication, yes, I'm getting better, so it's a dream come true. And then I think I will get started again and then finish it rapidly. I think so.
So author and businessman is not a combination you normally see. So do you think that your writing has influenced your motivation in business, or vice versa? Do you see them working together to kind of balance it out, or kind of what is your relationship between your professional life and your writing?
I haven't told you about the influences that I got from other peoples, and the influences that I got from my readings. I love reading, I can tell you, and I have learned a lot by reading. And that's why, yes, even if, for example, when you want to succeed in business, you have to read a lot. And I think it's the same path and pace, and then just you put together, and then you can get great. And then we have to notice also our minds are tremendous. We don't have limit. Our minds are unlimited, and that's why we can do everything we want. Everything. We can do everything we want. We can write as well. At the same time, also we can do business. We can do everything we want. We can sing. We can dance. We can write. We can be whoever we want. And that's it. And that's what I believe. Yeah, in fact.
Okay. Well,
I don't give myself limit.
No limits.
That's good. We shouldn't. We should work up to our fullest potential. That's awesome. We look forward to hearing more from you and viewing any more work that you do publish. Wish you all the best, and thank you again for meeting with us today.
Oh, thank you.
It's
very
been
much.
Great.
It's cool of you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And have a good trip back.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Here in Senegal.
Oh yes.
Very kind. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.